Today on the GG33 podcast, we are on location in this beautiful home, and we're here with Cleopatra. Who are you?
I am the mother of XXX Tentacion.
A famous 33 life path. And he is the one who puts you in this beautiful home, correct?
Absolutely.
You know, everyone knows, they've seen a whole bunch of documentaries on him. Let's talk about stuff that no one's ever talked about. Your son had a great love for the occult, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
Did he ever mention numerology, astrology, tarot to you?
He did, all the time.
Tell us how those conversations went.
It didn't go too well because I was raised in a Christian home, and it was just not something that I was interested in, so I was always dismissive. He believed that everything is written in the stars and, you know, all that stuff, and he had a lot of books on it.
And what years are we talking about here?
16, 17, on up.
Okay. And you weren't trying to hear any of it.
I wasn't trying to hear any of it. I didn't start getting into that stuff until after he passed away.
Is that when your regrets that you should have listened to him a little bit more?
100%.
And that's what you got me over here for now. tell people how we got acquainted.
Oh, wow. Okay, so I found you on Instagram and was watching some of your clips, and a lot of things that you say just make sense and it resonate. And I reached out to him on DM and I was like, I don't want any of your students. I want you.
My students are really good too, but I do appreciate that because they got trained by the best, so they would be good. But I do understand, when I talked to you and I gave you that reading, I didn't know who you were.
Did not at all.
I didn't know who your son was.
But everything was so on point that at the end. Mm-hmm.
You told, when you gave me your son's birthday and I started reading him and I said he was a 33 life path and I said this is an influential person, I had no idea
at all.
And then you were telling me, Wait till we're done. And I'm going to tell you who it is because I have no clue.
Yeah.
I'm honestly not surprised at all. I'm looking around. I've done my research on who he was. I'm not surprised at all. I have students, my students, who have told me he influenced them to go into the music. You know, our bodies go.
Right.
We're all going to go at some time.
Right.
But the influence we live in on this planet is eternal. I mean, think about this. Alexander the Great, Julius Caesar, Augustus Caesar. They're not dead because people always talk about them.
Absolutely.
Your son is doing the same stuff in hip-hop. When he was telling you about astrology and you weren't too receptive to it, what was your thinking? Oh, I'm a Christian. I just can't listen to this.
Yeah, I grew up in a Catholic home and, you know, Catholic church and just everything.
The Bible says.
Right, mm-hmm. Right. And I was just looking like, where did you come from? Like, how are you interested in these things? So, you know, I didn't really, like I said, get into it with him. I just let him do his thing. And
I don't want to turn this into a theology discussion.
Yeah.
But when people look at the Bible, and you know, the Bible says the animal kingdom.
Right.
It could have been referring to astrology and all the animal signs.
Exactly.
So, you know, maybe if people look a little bit closer, they'll see that
it's
numerology
right
and astrology is all over the Bible. As a matter of fact, it's all over all the holy books.
Yeah.
I mean, all the holy books have numbers in it. So if the people say my numbers and numerology is from the devil, what does that say about your Quran, your Bible, and your Torah? Tell us a little bit about your spiritual evolution, because you said you used to be very religious. I'm assuming you still believe in God, but maybe not.
I do believe in God, but I think I'm more so spiritual than religious. I don't believe in religion. Look at what's happening right now in the world with the, like.
When did that switch
happen? The shift happened after he passed away. After he passed away, I think that I became even more interested in understanding his mind.
Mm-hmm.
And then I started, like, really paying attention to his books. And then I started, like, I'm a YouTube junkie with when it started looking into, like, dates and numbers and understanding Chinese astrology and pulling up, like, even, you know, 15 and Aquarians and my personality. And I'm like, how is this possible when I'm reading this book? It's, you know yourself, so you know when something makes sense. And I'm like, holy shit, I'm reading it, and it's telling me everything about myself. And I'm like, okay, what else? So it's like, that's kind of opened it up for me.
Okay, so you've been on this journey for the past, like, 5 years?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. when it comes down to astrology, that's something you've been looking into for about 5 years. What about numerology itself?
A little bit of numerology. I still don't understand too much, but I know enough.
I'm trying to help you out there. Your son gifted you a book.
Yeah, Power of the Eight.
Power of the Eight. When did he give you that book?
He gave me that book, I believe, in 2017. He actually went and bought it himself to gift it to me.
And did you know that you
at the time that I was an eight? No, I had no clue.
Did he tell you where you were eight?
No. He just said, I want you to read this book. Two books, actually, The Alchemist and Power of the Eight.
Do you have any doubt in your mind that he knew you were eight life path and he gave
no,
you that
to? He knew. He would often say things that I, dismiss back then, say things like, you have no idea who you are. You don't even understand the power, that you have. He would say stuff like that and I'd be looking like,
you crazy dude.
Yeah, like, what are you talking about? But he was big on, your name. Mm-hmm. The power of your name, even.
Okay, and your name is Cleopatra. Has that been your name since birth? Mm-hmm. Cleopatra in Jamaica?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, can you show everyone your necklace?
My necklace?
Yeah, right there. So you have a snake.
Yeah.
Watch. The reason I'm bringing that up is because the snake bit Cleopatra. Mm-hmm. Is that symbolic of why you wear that watch?
No, not at all. It's just a coincidence. But nothing is coincidence. I don't believe in coincidences, right? I used to always wear the hair, too, before I even, understood that was her hair. And I did the wings on the eyes and all of that stuff. Just automatically. And I'm also very, very interested in everything Egypt.
Have you ever been to Egypt?
I've been. And I've been in an actual pyramid.
How'd you feel in there?
Amazing. I love Egypt.
You go there often?
No, I went once. I would want to go again.
And how often do you go back home to Jamaica?
Maybe twice a year.
Twice a year?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So the family still got roots down there and everything.
Yeah.
You and your son lived in Florida pretty much your whole life?
Mm-hmm.
Did he do any traveling? I mean, I know he did.
Not outside of the U.S.
Okay. Is that something he wanted to do?
He wanted to, yes. But he also hated flying. He hated it. Both of us. I don't know. Maybe we died in a plane crash in our past life or something. There's definitely something there. Oh, crazy phobia.
Planes haven't been around that long, so I'm not sure the reincarnation cycle works that closely. But maybe it's the fact that...
we're not in control?
Yeah. Sometimes when people are control freaks, they need to have control of everything. And was your son a control freak?
He was. Yeah.
So it was his way or the highway, right?
Yeah.
Can you tell us, besides the numerology and astrology, is there anything else he tried to push on you that you said, yo, I'm not having it?
Numerology, astrology, no. No.
That was the only thing.
That's it. He wanted me to understand who I am, who we are, why we're here. Like, this is just not, this is a system. This is not just... you're born to work and die and be on a treadmill. He felt like the school system was a prison. Like, his mind was completely different.
Yeah, I started understanding the school system was a prison around, I don't know, I was 14, 15, because in math class, they would always say, show your work.
Yeah.
I could just do it in my head. Like, when you give me your birthday, I don't need to.
Yeah.
I just do it in my head.
Yeah.
So I remember when they kept me after school. And they said I was cheating because I didn't show the work because I was copying someone else. I stayed after school. There was no one else around. I did all the answers and I didn't show any work. I'm like, who'd I copy from now?
Yeah.
So I always had a problem with authority too.
Yeah.
But I don't think I was quite as aggressive maybe as your son.
Yeah.
Did he ever have any trouble with the law?
Boy, did he ever. Yeah. A lot. All the time.
Tell us... some of the conversations you would have had with him after you bailed him out or something like that.
I would just be screaming and cursing in Jamaican, That's it. I would just curse him out in Jamaican,
What did he say, Mom?
It didn't work. Like, he's going to, my son just,
Could you control your son at all?
No.
No?
No.
Do you think it was just that he was that... that dude that was not controllable, or it's just
he was not controllable,
or you're just a single mother that can't control.
No,
herself.
He's just not controllable. I think also he felt like we reversed roles in this lifetime.
He felt like he was your father.
Like he was my father in my
and
last
he,
life.
And he felt that he was here to guide you instead of the other way around.
I don't know what he thought in this life, but uh-huh. He feels like he was my dad in our past life. He said that on multiple occasions.
How old was the first time when you said that?
Oh, what was he like, 15? I actually have a video on my Instagram of him talking about school and when he first started being conscious as a kid, saying, oh my God, fuck, I'm back. I'm back in this realm. It's on my Instagram right now.
He said that?
He said, I'm back. I'm back in this realm. And he talked about, you know, being in the school and being in the system. And stuff like that.
Did he talk about past lives quite often?
Not quite often, but he does believe that. He believes in it, okay. For sure. He believes that energy cannot be destroyed. So even if he passes away, that he will return.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things that he told me that kind of stick with me is that he said, when I die, I'm going to come back through you. I'm going to always choose you.
He's going to come back through you. What does that mean?
He said he picked me to be his mother in this lifetime, and he will always pick me in every lifetime.
That's some deep shit.
It is.
Wow.
Yeah.
What were you thinking when you have a child his age telling you this stuff?
Just thinking weird, you know, at the time.
Uh-huh.
Just thinking weird, but okay. I love that, you know.
I mean, you knew he was special,
me.
But
yeah.
When he says stuff like that, you pretty much dismissed it.
Dismissed it, yeah, because you know you're not conditioned in that way.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So it seems very far-fetched. Like, what are you talking about? You know what I mean? When he says these things.
Even though he died very young.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about his evolution as a man.
It was very rapid, very very very.
Like, when did it start to when?
He started giving issues, I think, at 13, like, but it was like really bad and drastic and then turning into what, 19 into 20,
mm-hmm.
It's like overnight, just a different person.
Did you have any doubt in your mind that if he actually was still alive right now, mm-hmm. he would have superseded Jay-Z,
100%,
Kanye West?
100%.
Do you think they felt that too?
I can't speak for them how they feel, but I think everybody knows because even right now.
They were all reaching out to him though, weren't they?
The other day, SoundCloud put out their numbers,
mm-hmm.
and I believe he was number 6 still in the world. He passed away 5.5 years ago.
5.5 years ago, and he's still
number six. In terms of doing numbers, yeah.
Your son's a martyr.
Mm-hmm.
Do you believe that?
I believe that.
Did he tell you that he was going to be a martyr?
No, but he said, you're going to see how genius I am when I passed away.
Do you think he expected to
pass
away?
Oh, yeah. He talked about that all the time. Talked about it all the time. And he told me that he wasn't going to make it to 21. Me and plenty of other people all the time.
Stop.
Yeah.
He told you a number of times he wasn't going
to
make it
to 21.
Was he joking? Was he serious when he said that?
I said
stuff like that too.
He was always serious, and that would piss me off. And why it would piss me off is because he believe in manifesting and believe in the power of the tongue and all of those things.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, you're contradicting yourself because one moment you're saying that, you know, like I'll laugh and I'll be like, don't give me a heart attack when he do certain things. And he'll be like, don't say that. Take that back. He always say that to me. So I'm like, why are you saying that? Like, you're literally putting that out. And he's just like, I'm not just saying it, I know. He would always say that.
And he seemed very confident when
he
said that.
He would always say that.
And that's exactly what happened.
Crazy shit that nobody knows.
Mm-hmm.
The day before he died.
Talk to me.
That night, he went to Walmart by himself
mm-hmm.
and bought a shitload of white candles. Left them in the house by the fireplace. Those were the candles that we ended up using for his candlelight vigil 3 days later.
Okay,
I swear to God, I can't make it up. We actually have...
How many candles?
I don't remember the number, but it was a lot.
I wish you knew. He bought... Did he
white
ever
candles.
Do anything like that before?
Never.
So he bought a whole bunch of candles.
Candles, white candles.
The day before he died.
The night he bought it that night,
that
he died the following day. Mm-hmm. That's why it had me like thinking, like, was he threatened or did he know something that I didn't know, or he wasn't didn't want to tell me because he didn't want to scare me. It was weird because I, you know.
When you gave me the birthday, he mm-hmm. died.
Mm-hmm.
And say it again.
June 18th.
Mm-hmm. 2018.
Mm-hmm.
I looked at that day, and based off the Illuminati, Babylonian Brotherhood, New World Order, whatever you want to call
yeah.
it, that's not usually the day they take people out.
So he was not an industry sacrifice?
I personally do not believe he was an industry sacrifice.
Okay.
I look at, you know, when people like Michael Jackson, people, you know, get taken out,
mm-hmm.
and they usually have certain type of numbers around them, certain okay. type of master numbers. I don't see that here. What I do see is a lot of martyr energy in that day.
Mm-hmm.
I see quite a bit of martyr energy in that day. We know your son was very into numerology,
mm-hmm.
was very into astrology.
Is it possible that he knew from that?
Yes.
Well, his chart, his birth chart?
Is it possible that you think, because you're around him.
Right.
Is it, like, a couple of days before he goes, was he acting funny? Anything different?
Like I said, he went and bought the candles. He wanted me to paint his nails black
mm-hmm.
that week, but I had to go to LA, so I didn't get to do it. He also said he wanted me to find him a monk. He was like, I want you to find me a monk. I'm like, a fucking monk for what? He was just
why
like, I want a monk.
Why did he want you to paint his nails black?
I don't know. I have no idea. And then he had a conversation with his aunt.
White candles and black nails.
Yeah, weird.
So in letterology, gematria, white, if you take W equals the 23rd letter, you break it down to 5, it adds up to an 11.
Mm-hmm.
Do the same thing with black. B equals 2, L equals the 12, break it down to 3. It also adds up to an 11. If you mm-hmm. go to Freemasons,
yeah.
they always have a checkered floor.
Yeah.
They always have a checkered black, white. Black, white, because that's 11-11. You understand?
Yeah.
That's what they're doing. So they basically have a frequency within that. So I'm looking at white candles, black nails, and
yeah.
then he goes in a few days. Maybe he actually knew something. Maybe
I don't know.
Maybe he said something. I don't think he was threatened.
Yeah.
Because if you're threatened, you don't act in those type of ways.
Right.
I'm thinking that maybe he just somehow knew that something was coming.
Yeah.
Maybe he just wanted to be a martyr.
So he believed that, by the way. You pick your date to come to this realm. You pick mm-hmm. your death dates. He believes in all that
and
stuff.
And he told you. So again, he didn't think he was going to live to 21.
21.
He told you that many times.
Many times.
He also bought a whole bunch of white candles
the night before
he died.
Mm-hmm. And he had a conversation with his aunt and just randomly saying, mm-hmm. you know, if I ever was to pass away, I don't want to be burnt. I don't want to be buried.
What ended up happening then?
He's in a mausoleum in the wall.
That's what he wanted.
That's what he wanted. I'm thinking that's what he wanted if he didn't want to be burnt. And that's the Egyptian. That's the Egyptian way, right?
If you don't want to get burnt
or buried. You're gonna be.
There's pretty much no other way to do anything.
When I went to the where he's buried,
mm-hmm.
they had one mausoleum ready.
Are you kidding?
It's underwater. It's underwater and it's facing the east. What's the significance of the east? The sun rises every morning in the east, right?
100%.
There's no coincidences, right?
There's no coincidence. I'm trying to tap into his mind through
yeah.
you know, in the last couple of days of his life. And I'm just thinking, you know, based off everything you're telling me, maybe somehow he knew he was going to go and he's doing everything he can to be a martyr.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this.
Mm-hmm.
Did he think that he was on the planet to change it?
Yeah, he did. And which is weird, right? Because he started out, I don't know if you, it would be good if you have seen the documentary, but he started out doing some wild shit, like street fights, like just crazy shit. But it got him the attention that he wanted, right? And then once he got the attention that he wanted, he totally flipped the script.
So let's go back to this
yeah.
genius, okay?
Yeah.
Before he's famous, he's mm-hmm. getting in street fights.
Street fights, like, you know, you name it. Always in, you know, problems with the cops, like the whole
and
nine
he,
created his bad boy image.
And he
basically.
Did that on purpose.
He did it on purpose.
To get a crowd. Because
mm-hmm.
he actually wasn't like that.
Yeah.
But he found a way to get his foot in the door and by being.
No, I think he was like that. What?
No,
I think
I'm
he
asking.
Was.
I'm asking.
Yeah,
I'm
I think
asking.
He. I think he was like that. I don't think it was a front, but I think I think, you know, maybe the growth or the evolution or whatever you want to call it, at some point, you know, something clicks like, okay, it's time. You already have.
Was that his, what, did he tell you that was his plan?
No.
Okay.
He didn't tell me that was his plan. He spoke about it after. Okay. He said, I started doing shit that I know would get the kids' attention. The fights, wow. The this, the that.
When was this happening? When these fights happened?
Oh, he started early at 15, 16, 14, street fights.
So he's getting his internet fame.
Yeah.
Building it up. And as soon as he has his fame, he switches.
Yeah.
Tell us when that switch happened.
The switch happened, I would say, because he was still getting into shit in 2017 when he got out of jail. Mm-hmm. He was still getting into shit. And then, like, 2017. Like, late 2017, the switch happened.
And he said,
leading into 2018.
Going into 2018,
uh-huh.
What did you notice that was different?
Difference.
He was more of a leader.
First of all, he had a half and half hair. That's when he was a tyrant, right? And he said the hair represent light and dark.
Okay.
Then he led into the white hair. Uh-huh. That's him, like, now shedding his old ways and right and coming into, uh-huh, all right, I have a responsibility to these kids. And blue hair is when he's arrived. You literally saw the changes.
Did you see a personality change?
Oh, yeah, 100%. He got calm. If you watch majority of his performances, he was always telling the kids, like you guys are fucking superstars. You guys are all gods. You know, mm-hmm. He would always, like, he was the only person that I seen doing that at the time. I see other people copying it now, but he was the only person that was, like, telling the kids, like, you guys are stars. Like, you need to know this. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm.